Championship Wrestling for 10 years, providing excellence and innovation in virtual wrestling. Wisconsin at the Fiserv Forum. This is the final Impulse before the Royale Rumble next week. Welcome to Impulse 97. We are just a mere 7 days away, give or take, till the Royale Rumble next week in Chicago, Illinois. And you are here for the final Impulse episode before that mega event. Tonight we have a stacked card for you, for everyone to enjoy here tonight, here in Milwaukee, Wisconsin tonight. In our main event, Salt Snake going one-on-one against Naruto Uzumaki, both men who are declared for the Impulse Rumble match next week. Just a little bit of a preview. Also, a tag team competition, the team of Goten and Jaeger will team up to take on Trunks and Dark Magician. A lot of rivalries between these two teams will be settled here before the Rumble. Also, Ken Masters will go one-on-one against Stealth 13's Hugo, will the Impulse Tag Team Champion have something to prove against one of the upstarts of Cell 13. And also, we've got in a few minutes, it'll be Eren Jaeger taking on Roy for the ACW Cruiserweight Championship. That match will be starting in just a few short moments, but we take it to the lounge as he has some important news. Well, there you have Assistant General Manager LaLouche Lamperogue stating that Goku will be back in just two short weeks for the British Invasion Tour, where he will make some announcements pertaining to Animania 5 and Impulse 100 as he gets set for opening contest. Eren Jaeger, the Titan, if you will challenge for the Cruiserweight Championship and will look to become a two-time Cruiserweight Champion. It was 2 weeks ago at Impulse number 95, where Eren Jaeger laid out the challenge after being shortly defeated by Roy, the champion at No Boundaries. He stated that he wanted one more chance at the Cruiserweight title, knowing that he could beat Roy if he was given a second opportunity at the title. Roy last week agreed and accepted the challenge. So we are getting it right here, right now, to kick things off for Impulse number 97, the final episode before the Royale Rumble next week. It's Eren Jaeger versus Roy 2 here as we await for the champion. Asking anyone that's been following the Cruiserweight division as of late, especially this season, there have been a lot of claims that Roy could very well be the greatest Cruiserweight champion in company history. And quite frankly, you've got that lineage that goes to the likes of Ryoma Edgison, Joe Higashi, Eren Jaeger himself, like I just alluded to earlier, and Goten. And all those men have made that title of some importance and significance. But Roy, I think, if he continues this, if he goes into the Royal Rumble next week as Cruiserweight Champion, if he can defeat Eren Jaeger decisively here tonight, I think we gotta start making the claims that Roy is indeed the greatest Cruiserweight of all time for Anime Championship Wrestling. As the crowd settles here at the Fiserv Forum, I would say it, the Cruiserweight title will be on the line here tonight on Impulse 97. Two of the elite Cruiserweights, not just in ACW, but arguably in CAW today, are scheduled to compete once again in the middle of the ring. A confident champion, Roy, raises the title high as he is looking to go into the Impulse Rumble match as a Cruiserweight champion, and then thus forth go to Animania 5 to challenge for the Impulse title. But Eren Jaeger wants to become a two-time champion, and he may very well do so should he be able to correct the mistakes he made at No Boundaries. This is our opening contest here tonight. Eren Roy 2 for the Cruiserweight title. The bell has rung and here we go. Both men staring a hole towards each other. They know what to expect. They know each other pretty well at this point. We're going to find out who truly is the best Cruiserweight between the two. As Eren and Roy do a little bit of bantering between back and forth. Here we go. Collar and tie lock up. And Roy will start things off with a side headlock. Switches it into a nice key lock. Eren played a little bit of chain there with a wrist lock from behind. A little bit of a hammer lock. And pushes Roy. I think for Eren, he's looking to not be intimidated by the likes of Roy. Roy and his great Cruiserweight title reign is not something that Eren should be intimidated of, or else he will fall very early. And I think that's the perspective Eren has at this moment, as Eren with a wrist lock towards the champion. Roy able to counter it, goes back into a key lock position yet again. Swings the leg from behind and brings Eren down back first. And both men are tit for tat. They are matching up pretty well so far. You gotta wonder if Eren and Roy watched each other's match at No Boundaries and realized the mistakes that each one made. As Eren pushes Roy back to the ropes here, the referee having to intervene, trying to break the hold, and he does. It's gonna be a very interesting night here tonight on Impulse 97. As we are just a mere short days away from the Royale Rumble, which will begin the official hype train, if you will, of Animania 5 in December. As Roy, with a nice shoulder block, takes down Eren. Eren able to throw Roy through the middle rope to the outside. And Eren might want to fly now. Oh, that's exactly what he's looking for here, Eren. Oh, Roy went back into the ring, knew that was coming, and comes back with a nice hurricanrana, takes down Eren Jaeger. Roy able to know that Eren was going to go for a maneuver and was able to counter it quickly. But Eren yanks the top rope down, and Roy once again finds himself outside of the ring again. And this time Eren will look to capitalize, go for a maneuver, but Roy, with a great, great intelligence, was able to move out of the way. As soon as Eren was close to the ropes, Roy was able to move out so he wouldn't be the back end, or the receiving end, if you will, of a high-risk maneuver from Eren. Like I stated, Eren and Roy know each other pretty well at this point. Both Cruiserweights are elite, and they are very smart and calculating in what they try to offer and apply with their moveset. Eren went for a right there, Roy able to block it, and here we go. The strikes have now been implemented. Roy, Irish with Eren. Oh. Attack was blocked there by Eren. Eren now going with the offensive strikes towards the Cruiserweight champion. Crowd in Milwaukee a little bit split here as Roy able to whip Eren to the ropes here. Ducks under. Leapfrogs over the challenger. Oh, dropkick did not connect there. And Roy with a nice jawbreaker onto Eren and covers with an uppercut. And Roy with these strikes here. Eren having to play second guess. Roy with a quick cover here. And Eren doesn't even kick out at one. That's dropkick there by Roy. And you can just tell this fast-paced action has thrown Eren off. And now Eren's the one that finds himself outside to think about his next moves. What an opening contest so far. We all knew this match was going to be something special. We all knew the second that Roy agreed to it last week that we were in for one hell of a cruiserweight match. And we are seeing it right before our eyes. Eren back in the ring now. Once again, Aaron's attack was blocked. Roy going back on the offense with strikes. It seems that Eren does not know how to respond to much of Roy's striking here early in the match. Here's a whip. Both men bump into each other there. Oh, Eren that time was able to stop it and yanks down the arm to attack it. Has Roy up. Look at this, a little bit of an airplane spin to keep Roy dazed here. Slams him down back first. Goes for a quick cover attempt here. One. And kick out at one by the champion. And oh, Eren with a nice clothesline. This may be just me as I'm watching the early minutes of this match, but it feels like this match is a little bit different than the No Boundaries match. And look at this, Eren from the middle rope with that nice hurricanrana. Sends down the champion. Another pin attempt by the challenger. One. Two, and Roy kicks out at two. Eren not letting up though. Oh, missed that attack there towards Roy. Roy able to capitalize here. Look at this, nice Frankensteiner from up all the way down. This Roy not finished yet here. Big uppercut, big chop. Eren finds himself back into a corner. No pun intended here. Oh, nice dragon screw counter by the challenger. Oh, look at this. Eren going to look for a little power bump from the ground up. Has him up there. No, Roy able to counter it into a hurricanrana. Quick cover here. Eren's foot was right under the ropes. And just like that, Roy is right back on the offense. But look at this. Eren now able to capitalize on this. Oh, my God. Handspring enziguri towards Roy. And you can hear that echo all around this arena. Eren not wasting time. Going for the cover. One. Two. And a shoulder up. What a match so far. Take a look at the offense so far. Roy missed the moonsault. And then Eren counters with a handspring into Curry, taking down Roy as we're back live. And both men are showcasing why they are the top elite talent in any cruiserweight division, let alone ACWs. As now Eren is focusing on that leg of Roy. Roy likes to use that leg to do a lot of knee-based maneuvers, and Eren is looking to take that out early in the match. And look at this perpendicular figure four. But Roy, knowing how that felt at No Boundaries, able to escape early. Scoop slam, no. Eren able. Oh, Eren once again attacks the leg from behind. Has Roy up on his shoulders here, and once again is going to go for another airplane spin to keep Roy dazed and grounded. I gotta say, Eren so far is working pretty smart so far against the champion, not letting his mistakes define him like he did at No Boundaries. As Eren's up top here. Moonsault! That time did not connect. Covered by Roy. One, two, and Eren with a shoulder up. Not done just yet. Roy getting a little flustered there, but knows that it's still early in the match. There's still a lot of opportunities for Roy to capitalize as Eren backs up, rushes. Nice drop kick, and Roy sent to the outside from the turnbuckle. Eren might be scouting. Can he finally nail that maneuver that he was looking for early in the match here? He's running upwards. Suicide dive, heat stick and missile. And Roy sent to the barricade. Take a look at this again. First of all, that dropkick sent Roy from the corner, and then Eren with that hit seat sinking missile from the ring to the outside, and now Eren is in front control as we're back live into this match. And what a cruiserweight title match you are witnessing here on the final episode before the Rumble next week. Eren and Roy, both men that declared for the Impulse Rumble 2 weeks ago or so, are focusing their match here. One, two, kick out from Roy. Both men focusing, wanting to become cruiserweight champion, heading into the match. Roy able to duck that basement dropkick from the challenger. Roy now from the ropes here. Elbow drop does not connect. Eren now from the ropes for himself again. Dropkick does not connect again. Roy from the ropes. Another Frankensteiner, and down goes Eren. And Roy once again is on top. This crowd in Milwaukee's on their feet. They're witnessing a highly anticipated, a highly competitive Cruiserweight title match on Impulse 97 as Roy Dragon screws Eren back down to the mat. Oh my goodness. And now Roy climbing on top of the turnbuckle. What is the champion planning to do here? Oh, Eren countered into a power slam. High impact. The cover. 1, 2. And Eren was seconds away from becoming a two-time champion. Take a look at this again. Great counter from the challenger in Eren. Able to slam him down. Went for the quick cover. But Roy somehow was able to kick out before 3. We are back live. And Eren Jaeger quick to capitalize here. Not letting this momentum go away so easily. Eren measuring Roy as Roy's slow to get up here. What will the payoff be for the Titan? Basement dropkick does not connect yet again. Roy from behind here. And a back suplex rotates his hips to give that added impact to Eren. Now Eren slow to get to his feet as Roy from the middle rope is waiting. And there's that powerful knee strike! He calls that the Binding Blade! And he's about to hit a second one from the corner, and if it does, it's over! Binding Blade by Roy! And that's what he did to defeat him! 2, 3, Eren shoulder up! No! Holy crap, take a look at this again! If one didn't put away Eren, Roy thought two would, and Eren was still able to kick out! We are back live, and this match continues to suppress a lot of people's doubts that these two aren't the best, and Eren counters that hurricanrana into a reverse powerbomb. This is insane. Eren with a big backbreaker takes down Roy. It's like a back and forth contest, and look at this. Eren with a moonsault almost was short on it, but countered it and capitalized on it. And wildly, yes, Eren with his feet on the ropes. Wait a minute, 2! And Roy with a shoulder up. I don't know why Eren thought he needed to do that. But Roy capitalizes after Eren was distracted. That's a little bit surprising from Eren, I'll be honest. As Roy counters and capitalizes with that nice spinning wheel kick. But look at this slow-mo moonsault. Almost didn't connect, but he eventually did. We are back live in Roy. Back on top here. Not going to let up one bit. Is he going to go for a Binding Blade here again? No! Luther's press from the top turnbuckle. Now, he's got the Binding Blade. Will he hit his other maneuver, the Blazing Blade? Which would be that knee-to-the-head maneuver that he does. Roy maybe set it up here with that insecure that he just nailed. Oh my god, he's gonna go for it! Blazing Blade! He got it! He got it! He got it! Roy has retained the title! He's retained the title here tonight! But Eren somehow with a shoulder up, damn it! I don't think Roy can believe it. Quite frankly, I cannot believe it. As Eren with a kick to the face to Roy. Eren somehow, the underdog, is fighting back against the resilience of Roy. Eren gonna run to the ropes here. Puts his entire weight towards Roy. Roy yanks down the arm. Not gonna allow up. Pele! Let's take a look at the replay here. The Blazing Blade by Roy. Follows it up with Eren's own Pele. You gotta know Roy did that deliberately to prove a point. We are back live here, and Roy's up top. Drops the knee on the midsection. Roy may be going for a Binding Blade. If he hits a third one, it's over. I don't care what anyone says. Binding Blade! Eren blocked it! Walls of Maria getting connected here! He's got him over! The Walls of Maria! And now Roy is fighting a game he does not want to involve himself in. He has got to crawl to the nearest ropes. All that leg work and back work Eren did throughout this match may pay off here. Will we see the champion tap out? Roy is crawling to the nearest ropes available. But Eren is sinking that back in very so tightly. Roy's got to do something here. I don't know if he's crawling, but Eren, oh, he's sinking yet again. He's sinking yet again. Eren could be seconds away from becoming a two-time Cruiserweight champion right here and right now. Will Roy's title reign go up in smoke? Roy able to escape it. Punch from Roy. He flipped it into a pin attempt. How does he do it? One, two, and Eren kicked out. What a match! This may very well have surpassed their No Boundaries match, in my humble opinion, because of the sense of urgency you are witnessing between these two. Eren, dropkick from the ropes! Take a look at this again, Eren, with his great agility and athleticism. Dropkicks Roy off the apron to the outside. Roy back in the ring as they're back alive. The urgency from both men to prove that they're the best, that they want to be champion going into the Rumble match next week. It shows here. But who wants it more? Whose resolve is bigger? Roy went for a strike, did not connect, but sent him to the corner here. Roy going to lift Eren to the turnbuckle. What is Roy going to plan to do here? It's got to be something big. But Eren has taken everything Roy has given him. Suplex from the top turnbuckle here. No, it countered into a Falcon Arrow! And you almost cursed! A suplex into a Falcon Arrow from the top turnbuckle! That is unreal! And now Roy! From the apron! Dropkick connects! And I think Roy's gonna put the final exclamation point! This has gotta do it! Eren can barely stand! He's only going by pure adrenaline! Look, that's press yet again! Roy could have very well pinned him here, but I think he feels he needs to do a little bit more! Blazing Blade, here we go! Eren countered the momentum and shift his weight! There's the Pele! And Eren's going up top! Can it be? Titan Toppler! Has Eren done it? We've got a new Cruiserweight champion! This crowd is incensed! And Eren has realized he has done it! A Titan Toppler! Has garnered him the right to become a two-time Cruiserweight champion! Eren Jaeger is heading to the Rumble as the new Cruiserweight champion! And reality has just set in that in his second time in his career, he debuted at WrestleMania 3 to win his first Cruiserweight title! And on this night, he has done it again! Roy had one of the best title reigns I've seen in ACW history! And there's no shame in him losing to Eren tonight! He held the Cruiserweight division to a high standard! But on this night on Impulse 97, Eren Jaeger proved to be the better man and the better Cruiserweight! Congratulations, go to Mr. Eren Jaeger!
Change.
Welcome back to Impulse number 97, and you missed, before the commercial break, one of the greatest Cruiserweight matches I have ever witnessed between Eren Jaeger and Roy. Eren Jaeger has become the new Cruiserweight champion. We want to take you to what happened during the break. All the Cruiserweights from Takoya, Shulk, Davis, Dennis, and Ness himself congratulated the new champion backstage as Eren will head to the Royal Rumble in Chicago as a two-time Cruiserweight champion. What a match, folks. Well, still to come, folks, in our main event, Solid Snake will take on Naruto Uzumaki in a little bit of an Impulse Rumble preview match as our main event here tonight on Impulse 97. Also tonight, Ken Masters will go one-on-one against Hugo. Will Ken Masters be able to beat one of Cell 13's very best in Hugo? But coming up next is going to be tag team action as it'll be Goten and Neji teaming up to take on Trunks and Dark Magician here tonight on Impulse 97. There's Zuko backstage here. Oh, CKO! Whoa! Out of nowhere, indeed, Sasuke did not forget about last week. And just like that, Zuko's been taken out by the Rogue Lunar and the Impulse Champion. Wow. I was wondering how Sasuke would get back at Zuko after what happened last week, but it looks like I got my answer. That just got really interesting, because Sasuke has to defend that Impulse title next week in a triple threat match against not only Zuko, but Kankuro as well. Where the champion does not need to be pinned or submitted for that title to change hands. Sasuke covering his bases apparently. But nonetheless, we get set for our next match here tonight on Impulse 97. As you see the prodigy Goten, a psychotic human being who has just done some pretty deplorable things these past couple of weeks. Is it because he does it on his own right? On his own merit? Does he do it because he has a vengeful spite against his own father, Goku? He's not even here tonight. He hasn't been here for like the past 2 weeks. I don't get it, but Goten in the ring as he awaits his tag team partner, Neji Yuga, a man that has a lot to answer for after what he did last week, to where he caused a title to change hands, speaking of which, I'm going to take you back to what transpired last week on Impulse 26. Neji attacks Yugimoto as Dark Magician defended the title against Hiei. For the advantage of the title, Hiei somehow, someway defeated Dark Magician, distracted it all with a third eye, and Hiei just like that became the new Intercontinental Champion last week that shocked a lot of people for it even happening. Hiei is not here tonight, but we can confirm to you here tonight that Hiei will speak. He will have his first words as the new Intercontinental Champion on the direct episode of Royal Rumble next week. Hiei will speak about his Intercontinental title win, and I'm sure he has a lot of things to get off his chest. That will be for the Rumble, that will be for Direct next week. Neji Ayuga back in the ring here. Neji Ayuga does not know the kind of territory he has crossed by doing this to Dark Magician after he failed to capture the Intercontinental title in his own right against Magician at No Boundaries a couple weeks ago. Just like that, the mood has changed here as Trunks will make his entrance next. A man that has taken issue with Goten's antics these past couple of weeks. A family friend to Goku, and disappointed to see how Goten, as you'll see what happened last week, he defeated Davis, attacked him with a chair, attacks Dennis with a chair, but then Trunks would come out for the save and take out Goten, and Goten wanted no part of Trunks afterwards. I don't give a damn what Goten will tell you otherwise. Well, the fact of the matter is that Goten is going to have to face Trunks here. And I just want to mention as well that all four of these men in this match are being declared for the Impulse Rumble match. Trunks and Magician declared earlier this week for the Impulse Rumble match. Trunks, a former Impulse champion himself, will look to go to Animania 5, hopefully by winning the Impulse Rumble and becoming a two-time Impulse champion. We'll be right back. Nautilus Dark Magician makes his entrance to the ring. Smoking off. Well, the smoke and mirrors is not here. The smoke and mirrors, excuse me, is not here himself. You'll notice Yugimoto is not by Dark Magician's side, as you just saw earlier. The next entrance, he was attacked by Ninja last week, and therefore those injuries have prevented him from being here tonight. So it'll be interesting to see how Dark Magician is able to compete without his master. Now granted, he has Trunks as a tag team partner, and quite frankly, that's a good partner, regardless of who you are, but I gotta wonder if Magician's sights are set towards Neji in a revenge sort of way. Without Yugi's guidance as his master, I don't know how effective that may be for Magician. As the former Intercontinental Champion is in the ring here, we get set for our second match here on Impulse 97. Goten is going to look to start out for his corner, and so will Trunks, and both men taunting each other already. Here we go. Goten's going to have to face the music here. Bell is ringing, here we go. Trunks wants a piece of Goten. Goten trying to bait Trunks, if you will, a little bit. And Goten runs away. Shocker. I don't think Neji can even believe it. Look at this. Neji telling Goten, what the hell, man? So I guess Neji will start off for the corner, okay. Man grappled, here we go. Trunks, the stronger of the two, will able to win that. But look at this, Neji pushes him off towards the ropes here. Ducks under. Leapfrogs over. Oh, and Trunks with a nice, perfect drop kick sends Neji back. You see Magician on the apron here. He wants to get in that ring. He wants to get his hands on Neji Ayuga. And who can blame him? Trunks now, look at this, belly to back, goes for a quick pin attempt here, one, two, nope, only ain't one there. Trunks, look at this, nice amateur style takedown, sends Neji back down to the ground. Trunks obviously the bigger of the two men, stronger than Neji, he's going to use his strength and power to override Neji's maneuvers. Big clothesline to the corner. Almost as a Trunks is showing Goten, if you step in this ring, this is what's going to happen to you. There's a cover. One. Two. And Neji will kick out at two as Dark Magician wants to get in that ring. And this Trunks sending Neji to the corner here. Very smart there by Trunks. And Magician's getting tagged in, and whoop, here's Magician's chance here. Double axe handle from the middle rope. And now Dark Magician has Neji in the middle of the ring. There will be no running. Look at that, a big suplex from the Magician. And look at that, a little bit of a cocky, arrogant pin there. Trying to humiliate Neji, and who can blame Magician? Who the hell can blame the former Intercontinental Champion after what Neji did to cost him that title? Magician was looking to become the greatest Intercontinental Champion of all time, and Neji foiled those plans last week. Still to come, folks, in our main event, Solid Snake will take on Naruto Uzumaki one-on-one in an Impulse World preview match. So that'll be interesting to see also. Ken Masters will take on Hugo one-on-one. As you heard from Lelouch earlier tonight on Impulse 98, the first episode of the British Invasion Tour in 2 weeks. Cell 13 will take on Shoryuken in a tag team match with the titles not on the line. As Magician so far is just right now destroying Neji. Covered by Magician, cover. One, two, and Goten breaks it up. Finally gets into this match. Here's a bulldog once again from Magician, taking down Neji. We're back live here. And now Neji's going to look to use some offense. And wisely whips Magician to the corner. And now Goten wants to play ball. Overhead neckbreaker. Kick to the back by Neji. Goten not wasting any time. Wait, he's going for the Prodigy Press already? And, oh, nope, nobody home. Oh, and a big clothesline. And Magician, just like that, is back on the offensive. And Goten might have picked the wrong time to come back. As Goten up for a suplex here. And no, Goten using his momentum to shift. And now he's going to have to use his quick agility to keep Magician guessing. A nice crossbody by the former Cruiserweight Champion. Goten using his quick strikes, quick athleticism to keep Magician guessing. Because although Magician's got the reach, he's got the length, he's got the overbearing power over Goten, obviously. Stuff like that is why Goten is going to be able to keep Magician down. Nice head scissors takedown from the Prodigy, and now Goten from the middle. Big senton! Remember, Goten is still a Cruiserweight, by the way. One, two! And a kick out by Magician. Goten being very smart, using his Cruiserweight maneuvers to take down Magician. He knows he's not going to be able to fight him one-on-one in a striking match or in any kind of ground and pound. Now Magician's back in, and look at this. Nice drop to hold elbow combination. The most overrated tag team maneuver in all CW. Don't you forget it. Now Neji working over the back of Magician. Neji, just look at Neji, just no remorse, no regret. He's proud of what he did last week. And here's a cover by Neji here. And the Magician's length, able to grab the ropes there. It's like Neji last week said, if I can't be Intercontinental Champion, then you certainly will no longer be Intercontinental Champion. So Goten and Neji keep working on Magician to the corner, keeping him away from Trunks. As Magician up here, stun gun on the top rope. And just like that, Neji bragging about his work as of late over the Magician. There is no Yugimoto. And like I just stated earlier during the entrances, it's going to be hard for Magician to really exact his revenge when there is no Yugi on his side to really guide him pretty well. As now Goten's tagged in, Neji has him up here. What is this? Oh my god! What a tag team move there by Goten and Neji! Holy crap, here's the cover! One, and Trunks broke it up because he knew Magician was in trouble. Now, we didn't see that again. Neji has Magician up with a back suplex, and look at this. Look at the height. Lay drops him with that combination of a back suplex from Neji. That is impressive. The match continues here as Goten sends Magician back to the corner. Neji once again tagged back into the match. Look at this. Rocket launcher. It's a rocket launcher. I got it right the first time. Don't judge me. I wonder who invented that move too. But I will let you guys research that. Look at this, Neji! With these Fatal Fury kicks towards the chest of Magician. Ah, buzzsaw kick! A move that Neji has taken out with many opponents in the past. It may be for Magician. And Magician luckily got his hand under the ropes. Or else Magician could have been done for. I'm telling you, without the guidance of Yugi, Magician is a little bit weakened. And you can see that in this match. Granted, he has Trunks, but Trunks has not been in this match since Magician has been tagged in. Look at that, Magician Oku driver. I may have spoken too soon here. One, two, oh no. And Trunks now get in the ring. Referee trying to retain order here. And Goten accidentally attacked Neji. And now Magician trying to take out Goten. And I think Magician's had enough. I think Magician is blind with fury and will take out whoever he needs to take out. Whips Neji to the corner here. And Goten knocked off by Magician. Neji ducks the clothesline from Magician. He's gonna counter here with something. What's this? No way! Oh my god! Exploder suplex! More of a T-bone suplex, if you want to be honest. From Neji. And now Magician's gotta use the ropes to get up. This is bad. There's a drop kick! Take a look at that dropkick again. Neji dropping Magician there as we're back live. And now Neji measuring up the former Intercontinental Champion. But Magician with a nice swinging neck breaker sends Neji down. And now Trunks is tagged back into the match. And Milwaukee on their feet for the future. I'm sure Goten wants no part of that ring now. Trunks kicks Neji down to the mat. Trunks is going to look to gain back momentum for his team here. Sends Neji to the corner here. Looks Neji as Goten tries to get into the ring here, but oh, no, Trunks missed that attack there. But Trunks able to yank Neji's arm down to the mat. And look at this. Gut Buster! And Trunks, just like that, has shifted the momentum back to him and Magician. Look at that half suplex there. And look at that, knocks Goten off the apron. I gotta tell you, Trunks is on fire so far. These men may be in teams here tonight, but next week at the Rumble, it'll be every man for themselves. There will be no teams. And Goten's back on the apron here. Oh, and just struck Trunks right towards the groin. What a cheap shot by Goten. That is ridiculous. But not surprising considering Goten's legs. Oh, man, there's a giant wizard. Or rock solid from Neji's former friend, Rock Lee. Oh, this is not looking good. Trunks to the counter. And now what's this? Another gut buster. Trunks is trying to fight here. Over to the back of Neji's head here. Trunks is still fighting a solid match here. From the ropes. Oh, that's a big clothesline. And down goes Neji. Crowd in Milwaukee behind Trunks as Neji's crawling back to the corner where Goten is at. And he may be looking for a tag here. Oh, what the hell? You knew it was coming, but I didn't think Goten would actually do it. Goten's walking out on Neji here. He wants no part of Trunks. It is clear to me and everybody else. And now Neji's got to fight this alone. It's deserved, don't get me wrong. Oh man, and Trunks is gonna end it right now. T-Driver to Neji. And that could have been Goten had Neji went for the tag. Goten is scared of Trunks, and I will hear no argument otherwise. But should Trunks face Goten at the Rumble, there will be no running. And I thought Trunks would have ended it, but I think Trunks understands Magician wants to be the one to send the message to Neji. Magician, Black Magic Cutter! And that is for redemption and retribution for last week. Neji is out. Magician going for the cover. And folks, it is academic. Trunks and Magician are victorious here tonight on Impulse 97. After Goten walked out on Neji, Neji suffers a T-Driver and a Black Magic Cutter. And it was all she wrote at that point. The coward Goten will live to fight another day, apparently. But tonight, Magician and Trunks were a team. But that will not be the case at the Rumble next week, where Trunks and Magician may have to face each other to determine who gets the golden ticket to Animania 5. We will find out until then. Big victory for Trunks and Magician heading to the Impulse Rumble.
Yeah.
What is up with Ken lately? I mean, you're one half of the Impulse Tag Team Champions, and you're raising this doubt of all times right now? I don't blame Ryu. A little bit of a drift between Ryu and Ken as of late. Still to come in our main event, Solid Snake will take on Naruto Uzumaki. And a little bit of an Impulse Rumble preview match. Coming up next, it'll be Ken Masters going one-on-one in Cell 13 Hugo here tonight on Impulse 97. Ken Masters on the stage here, and that was a bit of an intense situation between him and Ryu. I don't know. I know I've heard those claims before of Ryu, of Ken being like a second tier to Ryu, or being, for a lot of you Smash fans, an Echo fighter, if you will, but I call BS on that. We all know how good Ken is. He's one half the Impulse Tag Team Champions. He's been an XL Tag Team Champion. His career speaks for itself. And for him to have doubts because certain people are just saying these things about him, comparing him to Ryu, he's got to get over that. Sure, Ryu can have one of their best runs in their careers, and Ken is just looking to undermine all that. And this might have something to do with it. Cell 13 have become one of the hottest teams in the Impulse Tag Team Division, let alone the entire tag division of ACW. Cell 13 came in a couple of months ago just looking for an opportunity, and so far they have taken that opportunity, and they have very well have taken advantage of it for their own benefit. 2 weeks ago on Impulse 95, IGMA pretty much stated that Shoryuki needs to stop ducking Cell 13 because they want those Impulse Tag Team titles. And Ken Masters, to the detest of Ryu, said anytime, anywhere. Well, Cell 13 will have their chance at Impulse 98 in Northern Ireland for the British Invasion Tour as they will take on Shoryuki in a non-title match. But tonight, Ken Masters will take on Hugo here. And Ken Masters not wasting any time going after Hugo with some strikes and chops. Looks Hugo to the ropes here. And an atomic drop! And capitalizes a nice neck breaker. And for Ken Masters, he said that he didn't need Ryu on his side here tonight. You can see that high G-mates here for Hugo, but Ken is fighting this alone. He does not want to be compared to Ryu. He's tired of the claims that he is just second tier to someone like Ryu. Again, like I stated, I don't buy that. I don't believe it. His career in gaming, his career in fighting, his career in CAW, and ACW speak for itself. Why the hell does he need to think that him and Ryu are different people? They're of equal standing. But I digress as Hugo going after Ken with these strikes here. Front face lock here. Ken Masters not going to shy away so quickly. Kick to the midsection here. Ken Masters, big right, sends down Hugo. Goes for the cover. One, two, nope, only a one count. Front face lock here. Ken Masters biding his time so far. Snap suplex by the champion. And here we go. The warden getting involved in business, that doesn't concern him. And oh man! Hugo clipping the knee from behind. And that's why the warden is out there. That's probably why Ryu should have been out there for Ken to equate that nonsense from the warden. And look at that, an electric chair drop by Hugo here. And look at this. Drops the knee. Gonna work on that leg. Ken's stubbornness and paranoia may have very well cost him here, because Hugo's going after that leg pretty suffice. One! And look at that, Ken, with the in-ring awareness that he has as a veteran, able to get a rope break with his leg there. But Hugo is in firm control. And it looks like whoever's going to get the momentum here will have a lot of momentum heading in to that match at Impulse 98, when Impulse emanates from Northern Ireland for the British Invasion Tour. And we will go over the tour dates for that British Invasion Tour in a few short moments within this broadcast. As you go for the middle rope here. Waits for a groggy Ken Masters to rise to his feet. Oh, and a big shoulder tackle sends Ken down. Goes for another pin attempt here. One, two, and Ken with a shoulder up before three. Take a look at this again from Hugo here. Big shoulder block sends Ken down. We're back live here, and I think Hugo's going to look to finish it here. Will he, though, is the question. Oh, well, there you go. There's the answer. No. Ken with another neck breaker. I'm sorry. Neck breaker! That's a lot of, as the kids would say. No, I'm not old. Shut up. Ken from the top turnbuckle here. Big dropkick! And I think Ken might have hurt himself a little bit there doing so. But it did work. Cover. One. Two. And a kick out by Hugo before three. Ken Masters is getting a little flustered and annoyed from the referee's counting here. Well, that was a fair count. I don't know why Ken's complaining about little stuff like that. He needs to focus on the match. And look at that, shucking and jiving with some jabs. And the Warren should be worried. As Milwaukee stands with high kick, Ken, wait a minute! Rock backstage, you're brawling with Ryu here! Oh no! I was wondering where the hell Rock was of all things! But it looks like we've got our answer! Sending Ryu towards the wall and luggage here, backstage! And I don't think Ken's aware of it! He's too focused onto this match! We are back live in this ring here, Ken Masters trying to fight it off! Inverted DDT! And we're backstage, back live here! Oh no, not with the cutter! Oh my god! Front towards Ryu's face! Rock taking out Ryu before Impulse 98 here! Oh my god, no, 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 no! Oh my god, on top of the damn cart! Holy crap, we need to get some help for Ryu! He got a damaged spine, and Ken is still not aware of what just happened backstage. He's looking for a K-double towards Hugo. He's got it. No, he doesn't. Hugo ducked it. Surprise roll up here to cover. One, two. Oh, oh my god. Hugo got the pin. Hugo got the pin. And that's got to be devastating to Ken. A missed K-double that Ken usually hits accurately. Nowhere to be found. Hugo rolls up Ken unsuspectingly and gets the three, and cell 13, whether Shoryuken likes it or not, have taken momentum to Impulse 98 in 2 weeks. Ryu and Ken have declared for the Impulse Rumble, and they'll meet cell 13 possibly there. But man, you can just look at the disappointment on Ken's face. And that's only going to make his doubts even more legitimate in his own opinion. But folks, we can very well be seeing new Impulse Tag Team Champions in the near future. Welcome back to Impulse 97, and in 2 weeks the British Invasion Tour begins for ACW for both brands Excel and Impulse. On the Impulse side, here are the tour dates. Impulse 98 will be in Windsor Park at Belfast, Northern Ireland. Impulse 99 will be at the Hallam FM Arena in Sheffield, England. And then the inaugural Impulse 100 special will happen at the epic, iconic Wembley Arena in London, England. Join us in 2 weeks for the British Invasion Tour. But folks, it is now time for our main event of the evening! Solid State takes on Naruto Uzumaki, now! gotta be honest, and quite frankly, I think all of you will agree when I say it, you're looking at the top favorite in the Impulse Rumble match. A man at no boundaries that declared for the Impulse Rumble match and stated that he needs to go back into top form. He needs to become the Mr. ACW that we've all known him to be. A man that has had many memories in Animania history. He is going to look to win at the Impulse Rumble match. He is going to look to make history as to become the first person to win the Impulse Rumble two times. As you all recall at Animania 2, Naruto Uzumaki had to win the Impulse Rumble in 2008. Compete against Beast Boy and that person for the Impulse Championship in a triple threat match. Everyone knows what happened afterwards, where the rest is history. Well, Naruto's looking for a different outcome should he win the Impulse Rumble match. Naruto's opponent here tonight, Solid Snake. Also, we get part of the Impulse Rumble match. Former Intercontinental Champion, man that is looking to regain his footing after losing that Intercontinental title. If you notice, that Intercontinental title really does change a lot of people and their career trajectory. Just putting that out there. Speaking of that title, as I stated earlier tonight, he ain't make his first remarks as the Intercontinental Champion next week on the ACW Direct episode of the Royale Rumble. Speak, address the entire world. We don't know what he has to say, but I'm sure he'll have a lot to get off his mind. That'll be next week. Solid Snake is in the ring. We await for tonight's main event here. An Impulse Rumble preview match, if you will. Naruto Uzumaki going one-on-one against Solid Snake. Here we go. As you can see, Gary Oak on the side of Solid Snake, as he always is. Solid Snake has Naruto tied up here. And let's go do the referee's suggestion. Dare Naruto, and look at this, Naruto. Oh, look at this, just toying with Solid Snake a little bit, saying, okay, I brought it to you, there you go. And here we go, Naruto. Gonna whip Snake to the ropes here. And a big high-angle power slam takes down Solid Snake, cover one, and kicked out by Snake. We're playing games with Solid Snake here. Look at this. Oh, man! Drop toe holds him to the ropes here. And Naruto going to take advantage of Snake's mistakes. That rhymed. Anyway, back to the match. Naruto, on the middle rope here, awaits for Solid Snake. Oh, and a big crossbody! Naruto was able to hurt himself a little bit there. And look at this, Gary Oak already using his power to distract Naruto, and it worked! And I think Naruto was aware that Gary Oak being out there was going to be a little bit of a handicap for Naruto to overcome a little bit. The advocate, if you will, quote unquote, of Solid Snake. Looking to see that his client wins the Impulse Rumble match. Cover. And Solid Snake able to grab the ropes there. Order from the ropes here. Scoop slam. No, Snake able to get out of it. Kick to the back of the leg. Oh, and a big hammer throw. Just like that, Solid Snake has control. As Naruto now is going to have to find a way to get back. Big suplex there, cover. Naruto needs to get a position there. One, kick out by Naruto. Look at the Snake. Now he's gonna toy with Naruto. He's kicking his foot right on his face. You thought I was gonna say it, huh? Not right now. coming back with some offensive strikes here. A snake able to whip Naruto back to the ropes here. Knee strike was not able to connect. Naruto from behind here, back suplex, no snake, able to counter from it. And another hammer throw punch by Snake, and that's got to start doing damage here. Cover one, and another kick out at one. Take a look at this offense between these two. Counters that back suplex into a hammer punch throw. And we're back live here, and Saw Snake continues to control Naruto and the pace of this match. As I'm up, drops him down for a sidewalk slam. Naruto feeling the pain from Snake. Dare I say the phantom pain. Wah! Alright, I'm sorry. Okay, I'm out of control. That was ridiculous. That was cringe as hell. Back to the match. Naruto takes a double axe handle. Cover one, two, and a shoulder out. Snake not happy with the referees officiating there. A lot of people are not happy with the refs officiating. Yeah, they're stupid, but they have a job to do. You gotta respect their officiating. Alright? This is the NBA. Look at this big elbows there by Snake. Takes down Naruto. Snake doing a good job so far grounding Naruto down and neutralizing him. I gotta be honest here. I thought Naruto would have a little bit more of control, but Snake has really dominated so far. And Snake double axe handle. No! Naruto countered it into a backbreaker! And just like that, Naruto shifts momentum back to him. Cover by Naruto. He's got the cover. No, he doesn't get the pin. Only a two. Take a look at this counter once again. Naruto counters a double axe into a backbreaker. So back live here. Spinning wheel kick sends down. Solid Snake. And Gary getting a little bit worried here that his investment may not be all worth investing in heading into the Rumble. Big chop by Naruto. There's an uppercut there. Oh, blocked it. Oh, no! Shoulder thrust right down. Snake down on the mat here. Now look at this, German. And no! Snake able to counter the German into an arm drag. Whips himself to the ropes here. Big clothesline! Down goes Naruto! Snake over the quick pin of death! Snake could be getting an upset here! And no! Man, that would have been big! Can you imagine Snake defeating Naruto in the main event to carry white-hot momentum to the Impulse from the match? Especially with Naruto being the clear top favorite in that match. I mean, you got the likes of Gaara, and Roy, and Eren, and Luffy, and Snake himself, but it's clear that Naruto's a clear favorite so far. Went for a suplex, Naruto able to counter it with a knee. And now this Naruto with his own suplex! With a cover! Will that be enough to put Snake out? No, it won't. And Naruto now setting up for something here. Naruto's just going to continue to work on the neck of Snake. Cranking that neck towards an uncomfortable position. Crowd in Milwaukee, who's been hot all night, solidly behind the 7th Hokage here. He's up top. Could he be going for it here? Ninetail splash! No, it doesn't connect! And Snake could be matching it. Oh, it's Snake DDT! Oh, no, Naruto countered it! Northern Lights suplex! He bridged it! One! Two! Oh, man, Snake with the shoulder up! But still is down! Naruto measured up for something! Oh, it was a super kick! Covered by Naruto! One! Two! Game! Naruto Uzumaki! A valiant effort by Snake, I gotta be honest. But Naruto capitalizing on Snake's mistake. One super kick was all he needed to put Snake out, and Naruto takes more momentum with him to the Impulse Rumble match next week. Naruto Uzumaki looking to make history. It was 10 years ago that he won the Impulse Rumble to go to Animania 2 to challenge for the Impulse title. He is looking to make history yet again, 10 years later, to go to Animania 5 and hopefully this time win the Impulse title. Great effort. Oh my god! Damn it! Every damn time! There's Nora! But look at Naruto, he's got a chair! Naruto this time was smart to get a weapon to equalize Gaara's tactics! So what will Gaara do? Will he actually get in there? Will he face Naruto head on? Well, what? What? Help me? What the? Oh my god, not again! Gaara's gone! Where the hell did Gaara go? He was screaming, help me! And as soon as Naruto was gonna come over there, he disappears! What the hell is going on? I don't know, but what I do know is next week is the Royale Rumble. The official theme song for the Rumble is Taste for Gold by Jackson. If we want to thank him, his song available on iTunes, Amazon, and other retailers worldwide. Let's take a look at the match card as it stands right now. On the XL side, Ichigo Kurosaki will be in singles action. He will take on Mr. Smith's hand-picked opponent. We have no idea or no hints as to who it could be, but Ichigo is going to have to fight Mr. Smith's hand-picked opponent. Will he be victorious? The Glamorous Dream Team of Jerry Saw, the current Glamorous champion, Reika Hinamoto, will take on Ikumi Mito and Ina Yamanaka. Reika was attacked at XL a couple of days ago. Will she be able to compete and be aligned with Jerry? The 30-man XL Rumble match, those are your participants. A lot of star power. This may be the biggest, it is the biggest XL Rumble match of all time. Who will become the new XL champion in Chicago next week? Then on the Impulse side, King JJ will meet Kinnikuman once again in a grudge match. Kinnikuman has promised that King Muscle will make his return. Who would he, what does he mean by that, and will King JJ best him yet again? It's a triple threat match for the Impulse Championship. Sasuke Uchiha will defend it against Zuko and Kankuro. You saw Sasuke take out Zuko earlier tonight. Will Sasuke walk out still Impulse Champion, or will we have a new champion heading to Animania 5? And folks, that is your official listing of the 20-man Impulse Rumble match. One of these men here will be walking with a golden ticket to Los Angeles to compete for the Impulse Championship at Animania 5. Who will it be? Folks, do not miss it. It'll be next week. It is the Royale Rumble, live from Chicago, Illinois, at the United Center. Who, as we are on the road to Animania 5? Folks, this has been one hell of an Impulse 97, ladies and gentlemen. I have no idea what to expect. Oh my god! Alright, enough! That is 5 jump cuts tonight! That's gonna be a broken record! I only have one heart. That's Kankuro. He's arrived now. And after what just happened with Gaara, I'm sure Kankuro probably has something to say about this. Let's listen in. Hey, whoa, Zuko's got a hammer! He just ran to the ring, Kankuro! He sees it now! Zuko, no! Kankuro using the hammer against him! There's the mist! There's the mist! Zuko was attacked earlier by Sasuke, and now Kankuro will look to finish Zuko off! Folks, what is gonna happen next week with the Impulse Championship? We are just mere weeks away from Animated 5. Kankuro looking for a gore! He's about to gore Zuko out of his boots! And Zuko with a spine buster! Zuko has had enough! And now Zuko! Fucking on the sledgehammer! On the sledgehammer! And now Zuko's got the mic! And you shall receive. Zuko hasn't forgotten about earlier tonight. And there is the Impulse Champion. What is gonna go down? Jeff, keep it here for a minute. Sasuke staring Zuko. And Zuko just left the ring. Sasuke's heading to Zuko's way. Fox for me not be able to wait to the rumble here. Here we go. Zuko and Sasuke trading blows here! Come on, we're running out of time already! You've gotta be kidding me! But Zuko and Sasuke fighting back and forth! Folks, the Impulse title hangs in the balance next week! Animania 500 continues! They're still battling one back and forth! Holy crap!